Good morning. Today is Wednesday, May 20th, 2020. I hope you're all well. I miss you and look forward to seeing you all soon. I hope you had a chance to read the Three Crowns this week. If you did, you saw that this Sunday we have the Reverend Margaret Bullitt Jones. She'll be preaching. She'll also be joining us for a Zoom adult forum on creation care. I think it'll be a really great morning, so I hope you can join us. We also have Thursday night, we do Compline, that's led by Mary Street. And I hope you got a chance to read Miriam's pastoral note in the Three Crowns. Today, joining me in doing morning prayer is Alan Wilson. So let's start on page 80. Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. The Lord is risen indeed. Come, let us adore him. Alleluia. Let's say the psalm on page 82. Let's say Psalm 95. We can say that together. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are also his. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice. Also say the psalm appointed for today is Psalm 47, and that is on page 650 of the Book of Common Prayer. We can say that together. Clap your hands, all you peoples. Shout to God with a cry of joy. For the Lord Most High is to be feared. He is the great King over all the earth. He subdues the peoples under us and the nations under our feet. He chooses our inheritance for us, the pride of Jacob, whom he loves. God has gone up with a shout, the Lord with the sound of the ram's horn. Sing praises to God, sing praises. Sing praises to our King, sing praises. For God is King of all the earth. Sing praises with all your skill. God reigns over the nations. God sits upon his holy throne. The nobles of the peoples have gathered together with the people of the God of Abraham. The rulers of the earth belong to God, and he is highly exalted. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Today is the day that the Episcopal Church celebrates the Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ. So our first reading is from Acts, chapter 1, verses 1 through 11. In the first book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus did and taught from the beginning, until the day when he was taken up to the heaven. After giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. After his suffering, he presented himself alive to them by many, many convincing proofs, appearing to them over the course of 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While staying with them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father, "This," he said, "is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now." So when they had come together, they asked him, "Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel?" He replied, "It is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witness in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." When he said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going, and they were gazing up towards heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, "Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking upwards towards heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our second reading is from Ephesians, chapter 1, verses 15 through 23. "I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love towards all the saints. And for this reason, I do not cease to give thanks for you as I remember you in my prayers. I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that, with the eyes of your heart enlightened, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power. God put this power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet and has made him the head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I'm going to invite Ellen up here to read the gospel from Luke and to give a sermon this morning.
A reading from Luke chapter 24, verses 44 through 53. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you when I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written, that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things, and see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up to heaven, and they worshiped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy. And they were continually in the temple blessing God. The word of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The last time I was standing here, I was probably leading children's chapel. Children's worship mimics the liturgy in the big church with a gospel and with a sermon. And if the gospel is scary or mysterious or weird, the sermon is hard to write for 5 and 6 year old ears. But what a glorious first reading we have today from Acts, the Feast of the Ascension. The book of Acts was written by Luke, who wrote the third gospel. Acts tells us what happened on earth after Jesus' ascension to heaven. Acts is a blockbuster work of nonfiction, with one exhilarating scene after another, including the events of Pentecost, Paul's missionary journeys, including a shipwreck. And it begins with what we just heard, Jesus' dramatic ascension into the clouds. I always loved the image of Jesus physically being lifted up to the heavens. My image of heaven is a real location up, not sideways or down. Don't you just love it when a sports star hits a grand slam or catches that impossible touchdown pass and then points to heaven as if thanking God or thanking an athletic grandfather or a nurturing grandmother? Don't you too look up, imagining your loved ones among the host of angels, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting? Up in the heavens is so concrete to me, but not so much my neighbor, whose native language is Chinese. She finds our use of up so vexing. Why do we speak up? Why do we dress up? Why do we wake up? Why do we fix up an old car? Why is the drain stopped up? And why is the house burning up when it's really burning down? Regardless of the lunacy of English syntax, I am comforted by the word up. I believe that my personal host of angels recited quickly during the prayers of the people at Sunday service are up in heaven. David, Bob, Mother, Daddy, Merle, Ma, Carolyn, Maureen, Martha, and Fran. Just before his ascension, Jesus' final words to his disciples are ones of firm instruction. He says, "Stay put, and the Holy Spirit will come and baptize you, and then you'll go out to all the corners of the world witnessing to God." After that, he ascended up into heaven, and they never saw him again. They didn't really expect that. They probably thought that they just live out their lives in Jerusalem, maybe fighting against Roman domination, but certainly not going out to all corners of the earth witnessing to God. All of us have experienced what the disciples experienced, that is, to realize that God's plan for our lives isn't exactly what we expect. And when our plans are changed, we really need the Holy Spirit. Jesus, send us your Spirit and renew the face of the earth. You know our strengths and weaknesses. Transform us into messengers of your gospel for those who yearn for you. You know our longing for love and community. Make us instruments of unity and service, especially for those who are weak and lonely. Amen.
Amen.
you. That was lovely. If we turn to page 90 in the Book of Common Prayer, and we can say together a song of praise. Glory to you, Lord God of our fathers. You are worthy of praise. Glory to you. Glory to you for the radiance of your holy name. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you in the splendor of your temple. On the throne of your majesty, glory to you. Glory to you seated between the cherubim. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you beholding the depths in the high vault of heaven. Glory to you. Glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. And we will continue on page 96. We can say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and was born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate. He was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and in the life everlasting. Amen. And page 97. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. On page 98, say suffrage B. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance.
Govern and uphold them, now and always.
Day by day, we bless you.
We praise your name forever.
Lord, keep us from all sin today.
Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, show us your love and mercy.
For we put our trust in you.
In you, Lord, is our hope.
And we shall never hope in vain.
And on page 100, the collect for guidance. Heavenly Father, in you we live and move and have our being. We humbly pray you, so guide and govern us by your Holy Spirit, that in all the cares and occupations of our life, we may not forget you, but we may remember that we are ever walking in your sight. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you stretch out your arms of love on the hard wood of the cross, that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your Spirit, that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and to the love of you, for the honor of your name. Amen. Usually there's, during this part of the service, I like to take a moment to pray for someone or something. Today I'm feeling, praying for families, the wonderful job that Bryn Hollenbeck is doing with our young families, and how just knowing that it's difficult having children at home and having different schedules and working at home and helping your children with school work. And I pray that the path for all of us and for families with young children, the path forward at some point will be clear. So let's pray. Let's say the collect on page 829 for the care of children, number 46, page 829. Almighty God, Heavenly Father, You have blessed us with the joy and care of children. Give us calm strength and patient wisdom as we bring them up, that we may teach them to love whatever is just and true and good, following the example of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. And before we say our final prayer, I'd like to say the prayer that Miriam had written in her pastoral message from the Three Crowns. Be present, O merciful God, and protect us through the hours of this night, so that we who are wearied by the changes and chances of this life may rest in your eternal changelessness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And on the bottom of page 102, we'll say our final prayer. Glory to God, whose power, working in us, can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to Him from generation to generation in the church and in Christ Jesus forever and ever. Amen.